Hi, welcome to my channel Ruby Net Crochet Tejido. In this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to knit this beautiful shawl. It's very easy to do. I hope you guys like it and give it a try. And here is the list of material you're going to need to make it. If you are not already a subscriber, please subscribe and click on the little bell. That way you get a notification each time I upload a video. Remember, I make my videos in Spanish and English. If you receive a Spanish video and you want to see in English, go to the main page of my YouTube channel. Then you'll find the English version in there. Also have underneath some playlists. One of them is a Ruby Stedman English tutorial, and you'll find all the English version in there. Also, I have other playlists in Spanish and English, and you'll find everything you need to do this beautiful shawl in there. To make this shawl, I'm gonna use this yarn. It's the Loops and Thread Shimmer Shawl, 300 grams, 880 meters. The color is Sunburst Light 3, 61% cotton, 34% acrylic, 5% polyester. I'm gonna use a row counter. That's the marker as well. Other markers to mark each motif. And my 5.5 Chiagoust circular needle with a long cable in the description box below is the link where you can buy these needle set. I'm not the one selling them. I just mentioned it just in case you want to buy some for yourself. You're gonna need tapestry needle and scissor and measurement tape if you want to guide yourself by my measurement at the end of the video, once I finish my shawl. Another thing that you're gonna need is a 5mm crochet hook to do the border for the shawl. I did this sample to figure out the width of the shawl, and I cast on here 84 stitches, but it's too wide for mine. And I still, it's not completely open. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cast on 60 stitches plus 4, because it's multiple of 12, and I've had to remove all that much, and it's not completely open until the end. It's still a little bit, and some stitches a little bit very close to each other, the stitches. I'm gonna measure to give you the measurements, and I measure 29 inches, 74 centimeters, and that's without opening completely. Probably it's like 30 inches, 76 centimeters. So I'm gonna remove 24, and that will give me like 20 inches, 51 centimeters, and that will be perfect to throw in your shoulders. So I'm gonna cast on 60 stitches plus 4, and I'm gonna do 2 rows of net. Knit this way and come back with a net row, and then we're going to start with row 1 of the motifs. That way it gives you a nice little border here at the beginning of your shawl. I frogged all that work and I left the tail long enough to cast on my 64 stitches. The stitch is multiple of 12 plus 4. So I'm going to do a slip knot. And I'm gonna start casting on my 64 stitches. You're gonna cast on the way that you feel more comfortable casting on. Not everybody casts on the same, so. And you're gonna cast on nice and loose because we are working a lace pattern. So you want this to be able to open the same as the work that you're gonna be doing. So you have to cast on loose. And I wanted to mention, if you don't want this as open, you want a little more dense the lace, I recommend to cast on more stitches. You'll have to do a sample, and you'll have to use a smaller size needle. That way the work will be a little more dense. but I want mine to be nice and open, so that's why I'm using a 5.5 millimeter netting needle. And my work is nice and loose. So once I have my 64 stitches, I will meet you here. Once you finish casting on your stitches, you're gonna do two rows of net, like I mentioned. You're gonna net all the stitches until the end and go back with another net row. After that, we'll start with row one of the motif. I'm gonna start row one and I'm gonna place markers. That way, each time I work a 12 stitch, I know the repetition that I have to do. If I leave my work, for example, working down here, I don't have to count every single stitch to know what I have to do next. It's easier for me to have marker, and I know between those two markers what I have to do. So I'm gonna knit two. I'm gonna place my row counter and I'm gonna put it in zero. So I wasn't. Now the repetition of those 12 stitches will start now in the next 12 stitches. Knit two. Yarn over SSK. Yarn to the front for the yarn over. SSK, slip, and knit those two together through the back strand. I have a video where I show you how to do SSK more slow. I will leave the link here. You're gonna see an eye, you click in the eye, and we'll bring you there. And I've been working a lot with this stitch. It's very easy. Knit three. Knit two together. Yarn over, knit three. Yarn to the front for the yarn over. Knit three. One, two, and three. You're gonna place a marker and you'll start the repetition all over again. Knit two, yarn over, SSK, knit three, knit two together, yarn over, knit three, and so on until the end, where you're gonna end up with two stitches and they will be knit stitch. So, one more time, knit two. Yarn over SSK, and for the yarn overs, since we are knitting, you only have to bring the yarn to the front, and when you knit the knit stitches, you will create the yarn over on top of your needle here. So SSK, slip, slip, and knit those two together through the back strand. Knit three. Knit two together. Yarn over, knit three. Yarn to the front for the yarn over, knit three. One, two, and three. Place a marker and continue with that repetition until the last two stitches that are knit stitches. Now row two, and all the even numbers row are purl. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12, they're purl rows. So you only do the lace in the right side of your work.
I'm gonna show you in this row only how to purl. That way you can see how to purl the yarn overs, because purl stitches are purl stitches. And I don't need to explain every single purl row. So you see the yarn over here? It's just a strand. You pass your needle through that strand, and then you purl in that strand one stitch. And you'll continue purling all the way until the end. Just purling and passing your marker, purling, and so on. Now I'm gonna knit these two stitches, and remember to keep track of your rows. I'm gonna pass the marker, and now we're gonna start with these 12 stitches that you'll repeat over and over in between markers. So I did these two repetitions in Spanish. I'm gonna do the next two in English. So it's like after you do your two knit, you're gonna knit three. Yarn over SSK. Slip, slip, and knit those two together through the back strand. Knit one, knit two together, yarn over knit one, yarn over SSK, and knit one. You're going to pass the marker and do the same repetition. Knit three. Yarn over SSK. Knit one. Knit two together, yarn over knit one, yarn over SSK, and knit one. You're gonna pass the marker, and again you're gonna do that repetition. Three knit, yarn over, SSK, one knit, knit two together, yarn over knit one, yarn over SSK, one knit, and like that until the end. Then you're gonna finish with two knit. Now we're gonna work on row 5. I'm gonna knit these two. I'm gonna pass the marker, and we're gonna start with the first repetition of this row. I'm gonna work my 12 spaces first in Spanish and then the next two in English. Now for 5, you're gonna knit 4. Janover SK2P is a 2-stitch decrease. So yarn to the front for the Janover. I already have a video that I show you how to do this, but I'm gonna show you here as well. So you're gonna slip one stitch as to knit, and the next two stitches you're gonna knit together. And from the front, you see, you're gonna create that Janover, and you're almost passing on top of that slip stitch. But once you knit those two together, the Janover is in here, the slip stitch, and that extra stitch. So you're gonna pass that slip stitch over the last stitch. You're gonna do a Janover, and you're gonna knit three. Janover SSK. A slip, and those two together through the back strand. And that's the repetition in row 5. Pass the marker, knit 4. Janover SK2P. A slip, knit two together, and the slip stitch, you're going to pass it over and cast it off. Yarn over, knit three, yarn over SSK. Slip, a slip, and those two together through the back strand. And like that, you're going to continue until the last two stitches that you will knit. Now we're going to work on row 7, and in this one we have to remove our markers and place them back, because we're going to work in between the stitch before and after the marker. We're going to do those two together in an SSK. So either you can do what I'm going to do, remove them and place them back at the same time, or you can remove them all, and when you work in round 9, you can place them back. So you're going to knit one, yarn over SSK. So yarn to the front, and you see between this one before the marker and the one after the marker, you have to SSK. So you're going to slip this one, you're going to remove the marker, slip the next one, knit those two together through the back strand, and I'm going to place the stitch back to the left hand needle, and I'm going to place my marker, and I'm going to place the stitch back to the needle like this. Now you have to knit three. One, two, and three, knit two together, yarn over, knit five, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, yarn over. Those are your 12 stitches. Now I'm gonna move my yarn over to the back, and I'm gonna count my stitches, counting the Dajan over as the first one, and you'll see that I have my 12 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 with the one before the marker, plus the two after. So now you have to SSK. That's the beginning of the 12 stitch repetition. So you're gonna slip this one, you're gonna remove the marker, you're gonna slip the next one, and if you like what you do here, it's like when you're gonna do your SSK that you're supposed to do. You're gonna move those two stitches to the left hand needle, and you're gonna place your marker, and then you're gonna knit those two together through the back strand. You can do that as well. Either way, you have to have the 12 stitches in between the markers. Now you're going to knit 3. Knit 2 together. Yarn over, knit 5. Yarn to the front for the yarn over, knit 5. 1, 2. And 5, yarn over. Now you're going to have to start with SSK. That's part of the next 12 stitches. You slip this one, you remove your marker, you slip the next one, you pass the 2 stitches to the left hand needle. If you like it like that better, you place your marker with your yarn in the front for the yarn over, and you knit those two together through the back strand. And now you will knit 3, knit 2 together, yarn over, knit 5, yarn over, and so on. And at the end, you're gonna finish with 1 knit at the end. I finished row 8, I'm going to work on 9, you're going to work 2 knit. Pass the marker, yarn over, SSK. Slip and knit those two together through the back strand. Knit 1. Knit 2 together. Yarn over, knit 4. Knit 2 together. Yarn over, knit 1. You're going to pass the marker and you're going to continue with that repetition. Yarn over, SSK, 1 knit, knit 2 together, yarn over, 4 knit, knit 2 together, yarn over, 1 knit. And you can start to see the stitch already. Yarn over, SSK, 1, knit 2 together, yarn over, knit 4, knit it together. Yarn over, knit one. And like that, you're going to continue, you're going to pass the marker, you're going to do yarn over, SSK, knit one, knit two together, yarn over, knit four, knit two together, yarn over, knit one. At the end, you're going to finish with the yarn over and SSK at the end. And the last two stitches. Now at the end, you're going to pass your marker, you have two stitches, you're going to do a yarn over SSK. Yarn to the front for the yarn over, you're going to slip one stitch, you're going to slip the next stitch, and you're going to knit those two together through the back strand. And again, you have your two stitches back again, the yarn over plus that stitch. You're going to turn your work around in round 10, or row 10, and you're going to knit that stitch, and this one is the yarn over. You're going to knit that one in that strand, and you have, again, your two border stitches. You pass the marker, and you're going to continue purl all the way until the end. And we only have left row 11 and 12 after this one. For 11, we're going to start by knitting these two stitches, passing the marker, and then we're going to work on these 12 stitches. That is the repetition that you're going to do in between markers until the end. And you're going to finish with two knits. You're going to start with a knit one, yarn over, SK2P, slip one stitch, knit two together, and you're going to pass over the slip stitch and cast it off. Yarn over, knit four, knit two together, yarn over, knit two. Pass the marker. You're going to knit one, yarn over SK2P. Slip one, knit two together, and pass over that slip stitch. Yarn over, knit four. Knit two together, yarn over, knit two. At the end, you're going to finish with two knit, and next row will be 12, and that will be the 12 row repetition. Those are the 12 row repetition that you're going to do over and over. You look like this. Don't look like much yet because it's just one repetition. So you can write the pattern, all those rows that I've been leaving here in the screen, on a piece of paper. You can write on a piece of paper like I have here. And you can guide yourself by that, or you can go back in the video and watch all over again those 12 row repetition. I'm going to continue working off camera, and I'm going to do, you know, as much as I want the length. I don't want to count the repetition, because each time I finish row 12, I'm gonna place my stitch counter in zero again, and on my row counter in zero, and then I'll come back from 1 to 12, from 1 to 12, over and over until I have the desired length. But I will show you my progress as I go. Here I'm showing you the progress so far, and absolutely love the stitch. It's stunning and so easy to do. So I'll continue working and I will show you as I go. I have the desired length. I did 170 centimeters, 67 inches, and it looked like this. So I finished here with the repetition of row 12. That was a purl row. Now I'm gonna do another purl row, and then I'm gonna cast off the stitches. At the beginning, we start with 2 net row. We're gonna finish with 2 purl row, because it's the same but the opposite in one side. So after that, I don't gonna cut the yarn, because I'm gonna do a crochet border, because this tend to roll on the side, because I don't did any border for this. The 2 stitches extra on each side is part of the stitch, is no extra border, like I said. And this tend to roll, you can steam it if you like, but since I have tons of leftover still in the ball of yarn, with a crochet hook, I'm gonna do a border. Now in this row that I'm gonna do of purl, I'm gonna remove all the marker, because I don't gonna need them. Now I'm gonna cast off or bind off our stitches, and I'm gonna do with purl stitch. I'm gonna purl 2 together, and I'm gonna take that stitch out nice and loose, and I'm gonna return that stitch back to the needle, and I'm gonna grab that stitch with the next one, and I'm gonna purl those 2 together, and that one I'll return again to the needle and grab it with the next one, nice and loose together, and this is creating a nice and loose bind off that will look the same as the beginning of the piece. But when you return the stitch, you have to return the stitch nice and loose, because if you return it tight, you'll have a tight cast off. Once you finish, you will have a loop. You're gonna chain 1 with the 5mm crochet hook, and in the same space you're gonna do a single crochet, and you're gonna do single crochet on each stitch all the way around the shawl. When you get to the first corner, I will meet you here to show you how you're gonna work on the side. I'm gonna work on the first corner. I'm gonna do a single crochet. Now I'm gonna do another one in the same space. And now you can continue working on the side and each next stitch, you will do your single crochet. And on each corner you will do exactly the same, two single crochet, and that way it's nice and round in the corners of your shawl. Something that I wanted to mention is that once in a while, look at your work, make sure that you don't have too many stitches or too little. If you have too many, it will start to create a wave, and if you have too little, it will start to pull your work. You want to have this nice and flat. Once you finish with the slip stitch and the first single crochet, you're gonna chain one, do a single crochet in the same space, you're gonna chain two, and in that space you're gonna do two double crochet, one and two. You're gonna skip one single crochet, go to the next one and do a single crochet, and that is what we're gonna do all the way around. You're gonna chain two, in the same space you're gonna do two more double crochet, one and two, skip one single crochet, go to the next one and do a single crochet, chain two. See, it's a very easy border to double crochet. In the same space, skip one, go to the next one, a single crochet, chain two, two double crochet, skip one, go to the next one, a single crochet. And like that, you're going to work all the way around, a simple border, and that will look really nice all the way around your shawl. So I did the border here in the side. I did the border sometime skipping two single crochet, and in the third one I did the stitch. That way you don't get too many stitches and I start to do a wave, okay? So the color of the border changed because of the color of the yarn. You see here is orange, one end is yellow, the other end is orange, and in the other side is orange, and more to the pink side at the end, and here. Look really, really, really nice. So now I'm gonna show you the end result open, that way you see the stitch much better. This is the leftover that I have from that ball of yarn. I have 78 grams left. And this one was at 300 grams. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wrap this in my winder. I'm gonna wind them up, do a small ball, and put it away because I have another one of these, just in case I need more than one for another project. I have 378 grams left. Well, this is the end result, and look how gorgeous the stitch on this shawl. It looks amazing, I absolutely love it. Wear it like this, or you can wrap it on your shoulder, or you can wear this as a scarf with a black jacket, will look amazing. You can use this for different occasions, not just as a shawl. I love the color of this yarn, and it's very warm, and it looks amazing. Like you see, you can use this for different occasions. So I hope you guys like it, I give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel if you are not already a subscriber, and if you make this beautiful design and you want to send me some pictures, you can do it through my Facebook page, Ruby Net Crochet Tejido, or my Instagram, Ruby Net Crochet Tejido.
Please share my video with friends and family. That way you help me grow here on YouTube. I wish you have a beautiful day. Bye.